I'd like to yield 2 minutes to the gentleman from Nebraska, Mr. Terry.
Gentleman from Nebraska is recognized for 2 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise in today, rise in support of this budget because I believe it's the necessary thing, the necessary fiscal path to secure our children's future. I hear it from my constituents every time I go back home. We can't keep borrowing nearly 40 cents of every dollar we spend. This budget is a common sense blueprint that grows our economy. It'll force Washington to live within its means by cutting $5.1 trillion over 10 years and balances the budget then. Under this plan, we'll make much-needed reforms to the complicated and oversized tax code that will make Americans more competitive and create jobs. It will keep the promise to our seniors by strengthening Social Security and give our troops the tools they need to secure our country. This budget will provide relief from rising health care costs by repealing Obamacare. Families across my congressional district will be able to keep more of what they earn, which is exactly what we need to have happen to grow our economy. Right now, too many of them are struggling paycheck to paycheck under this Obama economy. Gas prices are still high and still volatile. And my constituents are paying higher health care premiums because of Obamacare. Families need a break, Mr. Speaker, and this budget gives them a chance to get ahead while holding Washington accountable for its stewardship of your money. And I'm looking forward to, now since we have a budget agreement, to seeing the Senate budget and when they'll vote on a budget. And I would encourage our friends on the other side of the aisle to keep Harry Reid's feet to the fire and make sure they do have a budget. I yield back.
The gentleman yields back his time. The gentleman from